Are you ready for this one? This is a 32 twisted easel. A 32 twisted easel, which I'm about to demo for you now. Trust me, this is like, as far as card making goes, this is about as advanced as you can get, okay? I mean, incredible, incredible card making. So let me just show you with each of the numbers. I'm going to have a little flick through and I'm going to find there's the two and there's the three. Now, I always joke on and say buying these for me was like buying, I mean, I didn't buy them, I just took them home, but it was like buying a set of number cake pans, right? So when our Oliver turned one, I bought him the number one cake pan. Then when he turned two, I bought the number two. When he turned three, I thought, crikey, I've paid an absolute fortune here. I should have just bought a set of them to start with. That is what this is, except you're not paying $129 for the set. You are getting the set for $55, way less than that if you remember in the club, okay? Now, each one of these comes with a die and a stencil. So what you're going to do is you're going to take them out and use them as two individual pieces. So if I do my die cutting first, I'm going to use some of that fantastic cardstocks that we get, you know, in your bundles. If you're picking up some of the bundles, you get the matching cardstock and paper. So I'm going to take the three and I'm going to do the three in a nice pink. And I'm going to take the two and I'm going to do the two in a lovely turquoise. And we can do them both at the same time and get them sent through your die cutting machine here. So there's our, the first port of call is your actual numbers themselves. This one especially, one of my all-time favourites because of just how detailed it is. Look, I'm going to squeeze both of these in at once, right? So we've got a 3D emboss. Am I embossing or am I debossing there? I'm embossing, we're all good. So with 3D embossing, you're going base plate, you've got your embossing on there, you're then going to use your magnetic and your top plate and send them straight through. And they're all 5x7, these folders. So basically it's like you're buying one, you're getting three extras for free, and they are some of our top selling designs, okay? So here we go, I'm gonna take these out. Oh, I know what I can do now.
Wowzers.
I've got gorgeous embossing. Let's add a bit of ink because we've got our inks on the show. Oh, I love it, Joe, when we're in stock of things. Right, I'm gonna get my ink pads out. Let's have a little bit of red onto here and let's have a little bit of blue onto here. And all you're gonna do is you're gonna pick up a little bit and just give them a lovely rub over and I can get a little bit of colour onto those beautiful designs. Right, so I've got the three and the two. Now, because I'm gonna do these on a twisted easel, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have them kind of overlapping a little bit like that. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use the black cardstock as a base. So if I know I want these to overlap just kind of like a little bit like that, what you then do is you take your three and you lie your three over the top, right? And then you lie your two over the top as well. So I've got the three and the two together, overlapping that little bit. And then you come in with your cards, your pen, and you just draw all the way around the outside. And the two of them connect together to give you that one big outside shape. Do you see what I mean? So by drawing around them together, you get them. Oh, let me just get you back into place there. Now, if I wasn't rushing on a show like this, Joe, what I would do is I would stick these down with a little bit of tape, right? So I've got my three and my two that you're going to draw around all at once. And then if you want to get really pedantic, what you then do is if you connect the three and the two together, quite like this, right? So if you hold them in place like this, and then you take a little bit of your low-tack tape and tape them together, right? You can lift them off and go and stick them on a little bit of white card, right? And then go in the next layer down, right? So all the way around, but your next layer down, and then you can draw all the way around that and cut that out as well. And you end up with a matting layer of, can you see, you get the, there's the inside one, right? And then there's the outside one that I've cut out so that when you layer the two of them up together, we're going to end up with a lovely layered effect to put our three and our two on. So I'm going to add on the 3 and the 2. There we go. That'll be perfect like that. Now, I'm ready to put these onto an... That's going to be the front now, ready to go onto an easel card. So look what I've done, okay? I've started off with just a regular... Here we go. 6x6 card base, Joe, and I've scored up across the middle like this, okay? So I've scored it up across the middle. And then what you're going to need to do is you're going to need to position on. So if you think your 3 and your 2 are going to stick down at the bottom here like this, right? So your 3 and your 2 need to stick down at the bottom so that when we twist this, it holds up like that. Can you see? So it's going to hold up like that. So what you then need to do is basically cut away, you ready, all of this stuff here. So all this is going to cut away, all that, all around here, all around there like that, and all of that's going to cut away. So you're going to cut all of that piece away. And what I've done is, I've already done that one, where I've cut all of that away.
Oh, fabulous.
Right? So you've just cut that away so that you can see that is going to line up there now absolutely perfectly to stand up. So then we need to connect it, but only on the bottom half. So just following the same principles now as a regular easel card would, a regular twisted easel, sorry. You only put tape on the bottom half so that when we stick this in place, there we go, there you go. That, I think, is so clever. It just twists and it gives you that, so you can see it. If you see it from the front, you'll see that twist there, it's coming together perfectly. And then all I'm going to do, Joe, is add a little bit of matting and layering. And again, this is with some of those beautiful cardstocks that we have now become like infamous for, these papers. If you go for any of our introduction to kits tonight, you will get a massive selection of these gorgeous papers to get you started. So really important that you do all your matting and layering. And then remember, whenever you're doing an easel card, you must always have a stopper to hold your easel in place. So I've got one here, I've just stamped a With Love. So I'm going to raise that up. And you see, if I pop that here, I can see where do I want that? I want that to stop about there. And my glue gun, it's going to be absolutely perfect to just put a nice big, need a little bit more glue in there, nice big globule of glue to enable me to hold that whole thing in place. So can you see what I do there? I'll get that ready, hold that down there, hold this in place, make sure that is going exactly where I want it. I'm happy with that now on a slightly lifted angle. It's going to hold that in place, and then I'm just going to have a nice little kind of extra little piece coming through there like that, I think. How impressive is that? A twisted easel, any number at all, whatever the birthday is, whether you're doing a twisted easel or whether you're doing what looks like a pretty basic card now, doesn't it? Just doing like the tent fold on the 70. I bet when you saw me do that card earlier on the show, you thought, wow, that's an advanced card. Now, I'm telling you, you can be doing a twisted easel. I mean, come on, absolutely brilliant. Twisted easel, any number you want. It's the sort of thing, whether you're going to use them this year, next year, or in 10 years' time, need to have them in your store cupboard at that sort of price.